Hello, you've reached Alan Rickman.
Who are you then?
I was an actor once. Damn it now, look at me. Look at me!
Walk with me.
Turn to page 394.
For people all around the world, the thing that most people do tend to love about you is that voice.
What?
It's impersonated.
When did you first hear an impersonation of Alan Rickman?
It's parodied.
It's Alan Rickman, reminding you to move the pork chops from the freezer to the refrigerator. Do not disappoint me.
But I was fascinated to know that back in the early days in drama school, the drama teachers weren't that keen on it.
Worse than not that keen. Yeah, it was a source of huge problems. When they tell you, you have a voice that sounds like it's coming out of the back end of a drain pipe, then you...
They did not say that.
Yep, absolutely those words. And how do you forget that sort of stuff? And you have a spastic soft palate, so you have to work at it.
Stay calm, this is simply the beginning.
Everybody's voice is an accident of architecture of the inside of your mouth. It's all to do with the roof of your mouth and where a sound bounces around or not and what your breathing's like. And so all of these things get taken apart at drama school and reassemble.
By grub Thar's hammer, we live to tell the tale.
The other element to your performance, both in this and other films, is that you have a wonderful sense of when to use a dramatic pause.
By grab Thar's hammer, by the sons of Warvan, I shall avenge you.
Was that a learned skill, or have you always just known when to apply a great moment of silence?
Well, I think, you know, when you've got real chemistry between a couple of actors, there's a sort of invisible wire between them that you can twang. And so the silence and the space between two actors who have really got something going on is tangible. And so I think silence and pauses are just as important and often more so than words.
I loved as you answered that question, the spaces between the words got bigger and bigger.
The Palace of Versailles shall be the heart of our kingdom, with gardens of exquisite and matchless beauty. Heaven shall be here.
One of the reasons why there has been such a gap between directing your first film and directing this was, of course, the more than a decade you spent playing a certain character in Harry Potter.
Quiet.
When you signed on to do those films, you didn't know where that character was necessarily going because the books weren't written yet. I understand you spoke to Jo and she told you one thing about where that character was going. Now, it's all said and done, the films are out, the books are out. Can you tell us what that one thing was?
No, because I said I never would.
How disappointing.
And it wasn't a fact, it was just something that made me know that it was a more complicated story and that there was a human being hidden behind the buttons.
5 points from Gryffindor.
And I think, you know, if Rafe was sitting here now, he'd say the same thing. He and I both had very strong outlines to our characters. You put on, buttoned up all those buttons and put the wig on and put the black lenses in and boom, you're there. You don't have to examine what he had for breakfast. He is who he is.
You know there's millions of people out there that desperately want to know what Snape ate for breakfast right now? There's like going to be a blog dedicated to it.
It was actually quite tricky because, you know, there was a day when they took me into the set, which was his home, and I looked around that kitchen and I thought, what is he ever going to do with that saucepan?
No one imagines Severus Snape cooking, do they?
Exactly.
I'm going to ask you one last question, which is you've starred in two very iconic Christmas movies, Die Hard.
This is Hans Gruber.
And Love Actually.
Almost finished. What else can that be? You're going to dip it in yogurt?
When it comes to Christmas, which would you prefer to watch?
I never watch anything I'm in, so...
Really? You never watch anything you're in?
It's not false anything to say that if you watch yourself, all you see is what's wrong.
You broke the ship. You broke the bloody ship.
That's no Christmas present.
That must make directing yourself rather awkward then.
Well, I don't look at the monitor for a start. I rely on other people, and in this case, with brilliant DP. She might be, her face might be behind the lens, but her thumb is either... Let's go again.
Excellent. Alan, can I just say it was an absolute pleasure talking to you. Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you.